In 4.3, we're going to focus on using the elimination method. In 4.2, you learn how to use elimination and substitution. If the instructions tell you to solve using the elimination method, but you want to use the substitution method, that's fine. The only part that matters is that the answer is correct, no matter which method you use. If you're going to use elimination, there are three things that you should be aware of. At first is, in order to use elimination, both equations must be written in standard form. An equation written in standard form means that the variables are on one side of the equal sign and the constant is on the other side of the equal sign. That's standard form. The second thing you must be aware of is that if you're using elimination, the signs must be different on the variable you want to eliminate. For example, let's say that you have these two equations. If you choose to eliminate x, that means that one x needs to be positive and the other needs to be negative. And we'll talk more about that in a little bit. And the third thing, it may not seem like a big deal, but you can miss an entire problem if you don't follow through on this rule. When you write the solution set, it must be written as an ordered pair. If you don't include parentheses, this is not an ordered pair, and the answer is incorrect. So make sure you write the ordered pair, which means it must have parentheses, and it must be in alphabetical order. Now, the first thing we're going to do is problem one on the homework. And notice that both problems are already written in standard form. So we have to choose whether we want to eliminate the variable x or y. Well, if you look closely, you'll notice that the variable y already has different signs, and it's already eliminated. So we can go ahead and combine the terms. 6x plus x is 7x. The y's already cancel. And 28 plus 14 is 42. Dividing both sides by 7, we find that x is equal to 6. Now that we have x, we can find y. And we can find y by plugging back into either of these equations. It doesn't matter which one we plug back into. I'll choose equation 2. So we're going to plug this into the second equation, or equation 2. So in place of x, we now have 6. And to solve for y, we'll subtract 6 from both sides. And we find that y is equal to 8. So our answer, written as an ordered pair, is parentheses 6, comma 8. This is the answer. Something you might want to do is take the time to plug your coordinates back into both equations. If you come up with a true statement for both, that means that your answer is correct.